Hey guys, it's Broken Bears, and welcome back to my FIFA 16 Olympic Marseille career where we're last time I left off. The second team. So, in the last episode, I had two matches. I won my league match pretty comfortably. Here, I beat Basti. Yeah, by a comfortable 3-0 score. And with the man who is in the little pre-match mini game before or the start of this episode, Otaka and Chanelogu, he scored a break. He's and assisted the other goal, so he was the MVP of that match. But when I played my first Europa League game, I won 1-0. I have to say, is probably the worst team I've ever played with in the entire existence of FIFA that I have played. I have played every single FIFA since like 2000 or before that. I've been playing career mode pretty much since FIFA 2001. And I've played with pretty much every big team you can play with, and a lot of the small teams. And I have never played with a team that just played so badly. The fact that I even got a win with this team was a freaking miracle. They were just dreadful, and as I was looking back, I was over the footage before I posted the video yesterday. I felt rage. I wanted to cut that part out of the episode and like record a new match to put over it. I wanted that match to be erased from history. I was like, no, this is good because
ball played to Mendy.
Proves that not every player is going to be fantastic under my leadership. So, I'm like, okay. Now, since the last episode, when I next play with that team, there's going to be some fucking changes. And if they cannot, they will have 5 more games to impress me, because they won't be playing in the cup. I don't trust them to get me through in the cup. I barely trust them to get me through in the Europa League. If it was the Champions League, they wouldn't be playing. The only reason I haven't deleted the second team is purely because I need a second team to prevent fatigue from all the Europa League matches. So it doesn't affect the league matches. Like, if my first team had played that match, yeah, I would have hopefully had a more comfortable victory. I would have enjoyed that match much better, but they would all be tired now. They would all be tired. And that would give Leon a bit of an unfair advantage. And I'm not complaining. I don't like to play about the fixture list. Is, you know, I'm used to the fixture list by now. Oh, I've seen every fixture or list multiple times. I've gone through every fixture list over the years. I'm used to all of them. But the Europa, but having a second team, what was that? Oh my god, that was hysterical. What? Freaking Umtiti, you better not do that at Barcelona or they'll kick his ass out. Oh my god, what was that? That was his. Oh my god. Freaking hell.
Well, they're gonna have to show some character now.
That is gonna be the most bizarre way to take a lead ever. I mean, under no pressure, out of nowhere, a random own goal. that's not the first time that's happened in the my career modes either. If you guys saw like a Liverpool career mode video there about a month or so ago, I was playing a game against Norwich, and Norwich keeper Ruddy did the same thing. He was, I don't know what he was trying to do, but he kind of like, he started doing kick-ups, and the ball, and he kicked the ball into the net, and I was like, wait, what? What happened there? The ball had been passed back to him. It's not like he was trying to kick it out and he just completely failed. The defender had gone for a defensive pass, and the keeper completely fucked up. He tried to do like a kick up or some shit, and the ball flew into the net. So, I mean, I don't know what it is with these crazy, weird own goals, but I'll take them. That's hysterical. Oh, from hysterical to unreal. Oh, Lasara Diarra. Wait, is it Lasara? I know it starts with L. Crap, I shouldn't have skipped past the little name mark so I could see what his first name is. Oh well. If I'm wrong, I'm sorry. But I think it's Lasara? Lasara or something like that?
Matthew Valbuena. Stephen Fletcher.
Yeah, what was I talking about? Before I was so, unusually interrupted by that own goal and the fantastic second goal. I was saying that the Europa it doesn't bother me. I'm used to playing in the Europa League now. It's always been on Thursday. I don't see why it can't be on Tuesdays and Wednesdays. I mean, it's not like the same teams play in the Europa League that play in the Champions League. It's not like there's a shortage of pundits who can't cover the matches. You know what? I mean, it's complete crap by there's no real reason why the Europa League is on Thursdays. I mean, I get people might be confused if there's two different European competitions on at the same time. But if you ask me, if I could change it, I would. You know, if I was like the head of UEFA, I'd say, you know what, let's put the Europa League matches on Tuesday and Wednesday. Why not? Why should they be on Thursday?
To make the change now.
It's just an inconvenience to the teams that are in the Europa League.
Move to Manchester City.
Because if they have to play on Sunday, and for me, that's what really is the problem. Whenever Liverpool have a Europa League game, I'm like, oh, for God's sake, I don't want to see another Sunday game. Can they put it on Saturday? Why isn't the game sooner in the week? I mean, seriously, have the games on Wednesday or Tuesday. That way you can have a few extra days for the players to recover, or the Europa League will get more coverage because people will go into see the results of the Champions League, we'll see, oh, the Europa League is on as well. Oh, I didn't know they moved it. And everyone will be a lot happier. And it's a way to make the Europa League more prestigious. It's putting it on, make it seem like it's on the same level as the Champions League. The way it's done, you're portraying it as a secondary competition. that only exists to give someone a quick route into the Champions League. And that shouldn't be the case for the Europa League.
Marseille.
I mean, by all right, have a spot in the Champions League. He gets a prize, but make it seem more prestigious by having it on the same nights as the Champions League matches. So you're saying in the Europa League is just as big a trophy, yes, just as prestigious a trophy as the Champions League. The way you do it, it portrays it as it's worth shit compared to the Champions League. It's like the Euros compared to the World Cup. Or the Copa America compared to the World Cup. They don't get the same limelight. Heat.
On EA Sports,
they should get the same limelight. They should get the same prestige beach built around them.
Fabulous clearance.
I mean, the Euros and the Copa America were both on in this summer. And I guarantee you there's a lot of people who say, Copa America was on this year? I guarantee it. There's a lot of people who unless they support a player who plays for some American team or USA, because they're in it too, for reasons.
Well, the hands that didn't look so secure look a bit safer now.
Yeah, that'll make him feel a little bit better about himself.
But I guarantee you, there's a lot of people going really confused and are probably searching the internet right now. Oh, checking to see if what I say is true. It is. It is.
Case of the die being cast.
As I'm sure you all heard, Messi retiring. That's what he retired after. After Argentina lost in the final of the Copa America. But you'd be forgiven for not knowing that because it got so little coverage. It was treated like a second-rate joke. And it's supposed to be a prestigious tournament. And I mean, it's not just the major tournaments. The minor tournaments get the stick as well. I mean, look at the Capital One Cup and the FA. Look how different they are. The Capital One Cup, no one could give a rat's shitty ass about the Capital One Cup. If you win it, you're like, oh, yay, a trophy. What do we get for winning this? A spot in the Europa League? It doesn't give the Champions League. That's the FA Cup. Why did we even bother? No, that shouldn't be the case. You shouldn't be like, whatever, we want a trophy. You should be, yes, we want a fucking trophy, it's brilliant, fantastic. Okay, it's just as good as the FA Cup, but no, it gets second-rate treatment and as treated like crap. And I don't know about the other...
tonight's league tables. At the top of the table...
I mean, like, in France, they have a League Cup and their version of the FA Cup. They have two tournaments as well. Now, I don't follow Liga, but if I did, I'd probably see either League Cup in France being treated like shit as well. It's a complete and utter joke. Now, maybe they treat it with respect. Maybe they do. But the League Cup in England is treated like an absolute joke. It's treated like it doesn't mean anything. When it does, it's prestigious. It's been won by so many teams. And it's treated like shit for no reason because the FA Cup is apparently better. They're both trophies. They both deserve their own prestige, their own limelight, their own day in the sun, for lack of a better term. The Capital One Cup doesn't get that. It gets treated like... cliche he's saying, but it's treated like a ginger stepchild. No! That's not the way it should be at all. It should be treated with respect. If you want a trophy to mean something, you have to treat it with respect. And the fact that the Capital One Cup isn't treated with the same respect the FA Cup is a joke. It's an absolute joke. And it should change. That should change immediately. It should be treated like it's the most prestigious trophy there is. Like it's the most valuable. It should be treated like it has to be won. The way you treat it, the way it's being treated, it's compared to the FA Cup, is like it doesn't matter. It doesn't matter who wins. It doesn't matter who wins the trophy. It doesn't matter who gets their name put down in history. It doesn't matter. Then why fucking bother having it? Either treat respect or just get rid of it. Because if you're not going to treat it with respect compared to the FA Cup, then what's the point? What's the point of there even being a tournament? Or if there even being a League Cup to win? If it doesn't mean anything. You have to treat it with respect. You have to treat every trophy with respect. A friend of mine pointed out to me that I demean the Bundesliga and the Eredivisie for being in crappy shields. I'm not trying to demean the league. Every league title is worth winning, you know. Where it be the lowest, almost unknown league like Eredivisie, which is the Irish league, by the way. Because a lot of people probably would be confused that Ireland didn't have a league. You'd be forgiven for not knowing that.
Now they've got a chance in this.
To the Premier League. Every trophy is worth winning. I just said, and I wasn't trying to mean the leagues. My problem with those trophies is the trophy itself, because it doesn't look like it's a trophy. It looks like the German and Dutch equivalent of the cap of the Community Shield. It's just basically. Literally, the Eredivisie title, and I know I just won it, looks like a fucking plate. What the hell is that? How is that supposed to look prestigious if it looks like you eat dinner off it? Do you win the do the players often win the Eredivisie, look at the trophy and go like, oh, I wonder what's for dinner tonight? Completely forgetting they've won, just won the league. Instead focusing on what they're going to have for dinner tonight. And when they go home to their wives or their partners or whoever, and the dinner is served, they're like, oh, that trophy is coming in real handy. It's one plate. Yeah. They should keep it like that. No, that's not the way it should be at all. And well, I'll give the Bundesliga kind of credit. Theirs looks less like a plate. Although it does look like you could still eat off it. Theirs looks less like a plate than the,
really good try to try and get his team in front.
Then the Eredivisie. But they should get actual trophies. The Premier League is an actual trophy. There's a reason no one cares about the Community Shield. And while I could easily make a case for why that should be treated with respect as well. As a lot of people don't count it as a trophy, I know. Whenever I'm making no honors I win in a particular career mode. Whenever I win the Community Shield with Liverpool, I'm like, do I count this or no? Because I don't know if it actually counts as an actual trophy. I know there's a match. No, you receive the shield itself, but I'm like, does it really count? I mean, it doesn't give prize money. It's really bland. I don't know. That's the way it is. That shouldn't be the case for any trophy. It shouldn't be taken in vain. You shouldn't be like, oh,
too early, offside.
This wasn't worth winning. This is a piece of shit. What did we win this for? What? Can we trade this in for something better? That shouldn't be the case at all. So I implore all of you, no matter what league you support, no matter what team you support, you should be happy with whatever trophy they win. Whether it be an English team winning the Capital One Cup, or an English team winning the Premier League. And I know I'm using the English League as an example during a French English League career mode, but I don't know that much about Ligue 1, and I don't know how they treat their trophies. I know Ligue 1 is the league, so it's true with respect, but I don't know about the Cups. I don't, like I said, I don't watch French football.
Steady at best in the first 45 minutes, still 45 minutes.
Just one of them. Didn't
quite have the impact I was expecting at the start, but time to remedy that. Mendy.
I think I have adequately covered for that, and I will take a freaking penalty. Thank you very much, Mr. Ref. Freaking hell, it took 60 minutes to get something. Okay, Hacken, that's gonna be a bad one. Yes, he just got it in. I thought he would miss. Like, when I saw where I had stopped it, I was like, oh crap, he's gonna blast it wire over the bar. I was half tempted to put it down the middle, and the keeper went the right way and all. Well, if he'd raised his hand instead of, like, obviously he was anticipating me going that way. I don't know why the keepers don't raise a hand just in case to try and stop the ball going into the top corner. I mean,
first goal of the game.
If I was a goalkeeper, I'd be shit goalkeeper. I'd be.
And here comes the counter.
I've never been good at being a goalkeeper. I was a goalkeeper facing penalty. When I dive to try and save the ball, I would be as committed as hell, and I would, you know, stretch out my arm. I'd dive one way, I'd raise my hand up to the corner, make sure you cover everything. You have to try and stop the ball. Well, if the ball goes into the top corner, your hands are then waist tight, and you're not gonna stop the ball if it's gone above you. And you never see a keeper doing that. I mean, is it to prevent injury or something? Maybe it is, I don't know. But I can't see why they can't raise their hand like they're a child in school asking the teacher a question as they're diving, raise up your one of your hands to try and prevent the ball from going into the top corner if you see the ball is coming in and it looks like it's going above you. I mean, if the keeper had actually done that, he might have saved the penalty. It wouldn't have mattered because Batshuayi's made it 2-0. Well, that would have been just 1-0, unless they scored from the corner, he would have probably conceded. But that's not the case. He looks good for having saved the penalty, regardless of what happened afterwards. Unless a goal came from a mistake he made.
About his immediate future.
Then he looks pretty stupid because his mistake cost the goal. But if he raises his hand during that penalty, he gives himself a better chance of at least making an attempt to save it.
9 remaining minutes. Martin Braithwaite, Florian Thauvin.
You know, I mean, it seems so unbelievably simple, yet he didn't do it. Campos is going to have to play in a very unusual position because Akachalogu is wrecked.
Tova. Cross towards Fletcher. And it's in the net for the goal.
Now, Fletcher's goal's not going to stand, unfortunately.
He's going to clear it up for us, Alan, I think.
Well, looking at the goal scorer, he was convinced he timed his run, but looking at it, that's a great decision by the assistant.
Here comes Oskampos.
Thauvin. Etienne Didot. Well, he's had a good look.
Well, that didn't go to plan, did it?
This period of play to add on 3 minutes.
Goal kick will probably be last kick of the game. No?
Ben Yedder.
Come on, ref. The match is over. Even if they score from this, it's a consolation goal. There we go.
It's 2-0, the final score.
2-0 is the final score. It took some time to get those goals, but they came. They came, that's the important part. The penalty from Hakan Çalhanoğlu and the follow-up goal full 13 minutes later from Batshuayi. He gives a 2-0 victory.
Liga 1, Angers 1, Stade de Reims 1.
And boom, look at that, look at that. For a early lead, PSG have climbed up to second on 17 points. So it's only a 4-point gap, but hey, that's still a very big gap early. Yeah. Even though I won't want one, I am realistically allowed one slip up. So in the next episode, I will have games against Anders, who actually played very well in the real life Liga. I think they finished in like the top 6. I know they outdid They outperformed what people expected of them. They didn't quite do a Leicester, because PSG don't allow anyone else to win the league. But that's, you know, they did as well as they did better than what people were expecting. And I have my second Europa League game, where you will see just what I have done to the second team. Trust me, the second team will need to impress. They will need to impress against Gothenburg, who I still think are Swedish. I could be wrong, but until I've been proven wrong, I'm going to say they're Swedish, because I was right about Krasnodar being from Russia. So Gothenburg might be German, but I think they're Swedish. I'm going to go with Swedish. So, tune in the next episode to see what happens in those two matches. Smash the like button. Smash the like button if you enjoyed this episode. So subscribe so you don't miss any future reviews from me. And until next time, I hope you all have a very, very nice day. Peace.